Ready. I'm at the three country point in the Netherlands. This is the split between Germany, Belgium and the Netherlands. From here I'm gonna ride 600 kilometers non-stop through all 12 provinces to Noordkaap, the most northerly point in the country. And I'm gonna do that in 24 hours. That's a challenge. Let's go. Welkom in Gelderland. Boom.
I'm always a bit nervous and my legs always feel terrible the day before a day like this. But my experience is it's always it will be okay. 12 degrees right now, so it's cold.
Good morning. 6:30, we're on our way to the starting point. 30 minutes from now, I plan to start a 600 kilometer non-stop, passing all 12 provinces of the Netherlands. Okay.
That's in 2015.
Really?
So yeah.
Wow, that's cool, man.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for joining.
My name is Stefan. I'm from Heidelberg. Best regards to RSV Heidelberg. It's my home cycling club.
No, I will join you for about 70 kilometers.
Nice.
Last minute shit.
Awesome car.
Yeah.
In Heidelberg about 4 hours, but I was at home, so 2.5 hours.
Right now I'm in Germany, this is the Netherlands, and this is Belgium. See you on the road.
This whole challenge was all about the route. With the uncertainty around the global pandemic, I decided it had to be in my home country, the Netherlands. Since the country is pretty flat, I thought of a long distance challenge. However, the country is actually not that big either. So I had to be creative. I would ride from the most southern point all the way to the most northern point by passing all 12 provinces along the way. This drastically increased the total distance to almost 600 kilometers. To raise the challenge, I wanted to complete this in one ride within 24 hours. I built a route in Strava and downloaded it to my navigation computer. I was using the Trim 1 for this challenge because it has a really big and bright screen and a solar panel to keep it charged during the ride.
Okay, here we go. See you on the other side.
I started at the highest elevation point in the country, 322 meters above sea level. So I had a fast and easy start of this crazy day ahead of me. And one thing that definitely helped was that Stefan was riding along at the beginning. From here on, I had 11 other provinces to cross and over 570 kilometers to ride. How I would feel at the end of the day, I couldn't imagine. I could only experience.
We are about 40 minutes in the ride now, starting with Stefan. This dude is 2.5 meters tall, 100 kilos. So he's pulling me quite a bit, so that's pretty good. Sun is rising. Sun's out, guns out, guns out. Looking forward to the next 500 kilometers. A little bit over 2 hours on the clock right now. Actually going really fast. Average speed 33.5. Giving food from the car works very good, especially on the road where it's very quiet like this. So I still have a banana, canned ball, a couple gels, so I'm good for 2 hours. We still have 496 kilometers to go.
A few moments later.
Okay, Stefan, thank you so much for joining.
That's awesome.
Good to see you another time. Good luck on your way back.
You too, for lasting 500 kilometers.
Now that Stefan had turned around, it was up to me. I was riding into a headwind for the coming 100 kilometers all the way to the west. And I had no idea for how long I was gonna ride by myself or if anyone would ever even join me during this ride. I had planned the route very thoroughly, but there was no way I could check every single piece of road of the entire ride. So I ended up on a very, very bad strip of dirt, and all I was hoping for was not to go flat, because for some reason at this point the follow car was not close to me. I prepared this challenge to the details. Most preparation time actually went into the logistics and stuff like the follow car, the cameraman, the clothing, the food, hotels, a different bike, wheels, tires, navigation equipment, and the route. A major part was the route. And during the challenge, I shared a live GPS location so other cycling fanatics were able to pinpoint my position and join me for a ride. This worked flawlessly, and it didn't take long till a few others joined me again.
Jeroen Hefkens, Instagram Mr. K-Dance, here to support Jasper.
I'm in Veldhuizen. I'm also here to support Jasper on this trip.
Till I'm out of energy.
Goedemorgen.
Hey, goedemorgen.
No time to lose. We have about 170k on the clock. We're passing the city of Breda at the moment. We had to deviate from the route because there was a road closure, but we have a local rider. He knows exactly where we're going, so that's good. The first 200k are in the books. Maybe 50 kilometers ago, an hour ago, I started to feel a little bit worse. My legs were getting tired, but now I actually feel very good.
I'm amazed by this group. There's six guys blocking the wind. We're going into the wind for the last 2 hours. These guys, we have a gruppetto, we have a peloton. This is amazing. All the way up to Zeeland, we have a headwind, and then we're gonna turn around and go to the northeast, and I expect a tailwind from there, so it's good. In this ride, my longest ride ever, a couple years ago, was 266. 10K from now, I've done my longest ride ever. And then I have another 300 to go. Insane. Current feeling, my legs are actually pretty good. My butt hurts. And my neck is starting to get a bit sore.
Soon after.
That's it. Officially my longest ride I've ever done. 266.1 kilometer. 303.5K to go.
The next one.
The next one. Now.
You help.
Tot in de beeld, hè?
Thanks. 230K. He joined me. .340 on the clock. 230 to go. I think my legs are starting to feel better and better now, so that's a good thing.
How's the ass?
Yeah, my ass is a bit sore. It's not getting worse, so that's okay. Two guys left, three guys joined, so the group is constantly like four, five, six riders. Got my racing buddy right here, he just joined.
On the commuter bike.
On the commuter bike. Yeah, it's awesome. I'm feeling very good, actually. From here, it's only 210k to go. It's only 210k to go. I think in the night there's not gonna be six guys around me the whole time, so it might be a little bit tough.
So
but now it's good. The 360 kilometer point was the only stop in this ride that I had planned ahead, just to get a little bit of food and to put on some warm clothing for the night. I got an incredible boost from Daisy and my boys, and I was ready for the last part of this ride in the dark.
Cycling fanatic, jongen! Dit is al de derde keer!
Ja, laatste keer!
Gozer, thanks! Dankjewel!
Graag gedaan!
Goeie reis naar huis!
Ja,
doei!
The group is getting a bit smaller right now. It's just me and Timo. Timo's gonna stay with me for maybe another hour. And then it's dark, I'm riding in the night. And I'm not sure if anyone's gonna join me until the end point. I just smashed on a record. My previous longest ride was on June 6th, 2013, when I rode up Alpe d'Huez 7 times in a row. That took me 11 and a half hours. I've now been on the bike for more than 12, and I still have a long way to go. Welkom in Gelderland. Boom. Limburg, Brabant, Zeeland, Zuid-Holland, Noord-Holland, Utrecht, Flevoland, Gelderland. Hey, dit is de 8e provincie. Provincie nummer 8. Gelderland. Witte G. Kom jij vandaan? I don't know what to say. I'm just gonna keep on going. He's gonna ride back. So from here on, I'm alone. 160k by myself. I've done that before, but not after doing 410 already. So we'll see. I feel good.
Thank you well. Super cool.
I needed a new challenge. I wanted something new, something that nobody had done before. And I didn't know if I could do it, but for some reason, if I have a challenge, that's when I feel at my best. I said this before, the bigger the challenge, the bigger the accomplishment. And you never know, it could happen. Maybe I get cramps, maybe my back is gonna fail. We still have a few hours.
1 hour later.
Stein! Popped up out of nowhere! Vanaf nu vloeibare voeding, dus B en D.
Oké.
One of the most important factors of succeeding an ultra endurance event like this is nutrition. If you don't eat enough, you'll empty the tank early and it's over. If you eat too much or the wrong food and you get stomach issues, it's over. A few weeks ago, I had a talk with ultra endurance specialist Evan Stevenhart, and he gave me a tip to use a lot of liquid foods. I had planned to be in touch with the follow car at least every 2 hours to get nutrition for the upcoming 2 hours. I prepared 4 food combinations, A, B, C, and D, that would each fuel me for 2 hours at a time, going from more solid to more liquid food respectively. All combinations contained liquid food in the form of gels and a drink mix, and all contained between the 75 and 90 grams of carbohydrates for every hour. I would just communicate the letter to the follow car and they would prepare the package.
How cool is this? A random dude on the side of the road hands me a bag of food. There is so much support on the road, next to the road. It's crazy. Cycling fanatics.
Later.
So, right now I have 83.6 kilometers to go. I still feel good. The only thing is my butt hurts a bit. Every time I stand up, it's okay. And then when I try to sit on the saddle, it's like, oh. So I have this number here that counts down because that's how much we have to go. And that's kind of funny to look at. But then I scroll and then I see I have done 487 kilometers. I'm like, what? Who's crazy? 487. And my heart rate is really low. Like the last hour, it's been 118. So it's going down. Further and further. This is the speed. And this is the map. Super clear.
About 10k ago, my route came across a bike lane. So the car, you know, I saw them turn around. I know they're going to be trying their best to be here as fast as possible. I'm kind of out of water, so I really hope that I'm gonna see them soon.
So we followed Jasper, but we couldn't continue because there was a pole. So now we have to turn on this very little road. Ja, nog een stukje verder. Ja, kan nog. Ja, 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 nee, dat kan nog wel.
So now we have to find Jasper again.
We will find him.
Is hij hier?
Ja, dat is goed. Jasper die rijdt een stukje verder. Hier zit Jasper.
I'm riding under the stars, solo, through the night, after, what is it, 15 hours of riding. How crazy can life be?
Much, much later.
So, there I was riding solo for a while. In the middle of the night, pitch black, dead quiet streets. I felt really good and I was pushing pretty hard. And just when I passed the border into the last province, as I was approaching the city of Groningen, two guys loomed up out of the dark. As two pocket rockets, they flew past me yelling, "We're here to pull you past Groningen!" Dude, I was so excited.
Hey! Woohoo! 35! Of harder! Rustig accelereren! Top! Ja, gaat goed, ik voel
kwamen ook even hard aan afzetten, hè?
Schieten ineens de auto voorbij?
Ja, ouwe.
So these guys escorted me through the city, which they knew like the back of their hand. We absolutely raced through the city and meanwhile picked up two guys along the way that continue with me further north.
We are at the end of the world.
Nou kijk, er staat daar.
Er staat een bord. We gaan naar het bord kijken.
So we're in the middle of nowhere. We have to go to Noordkaap. Jasper, what did you do to us?
And Jasper is like 5 minutes behind us. And I don't know how far we still have to go.
Yes. You see? Jasper, we found it.
Mag deze erbij?
Kom ze aan, ja.
Hey, Jerry! Ja, we gaan als een spier.
The feeling I had those last 10 kilometers, I can't put it in words. After riding 560 kilometers, I was feeling so strong. It was crazy. I felt I had so much energy, and just knowing I was gonna be there very soon, but also just because every piece of the puzzle just fell in place. I started seeing those blinking lights of the follow car.
Paardje ook niet. Nou, laatste stukje nog even 500 watt gefietst. Even kijken hoor.
Jullie hebben het gedaan.
Woehoe. 571.3 kilometers, 17 hours, 35 minutes, 51 seconds. Crazy Cross Country Challenge 2020. We did it. Ah, ik vind het best goed.
Goed zo gedaan, jongen.
Bedankt, hè?
Gedaan. Trui voor jou.
Hé, Bruno, jij ook bedankt. Ja, Bruno, die heeft ons een paar keer de weg moeten wijzen, jongens.
Wow. It's insane. I cannot believe. After 17 and a half hours, I go to the front, I start pushing 350 watts. Like it's nothing. I feel great. Whoa, I'm gonna pop it. I did not expect to have these guys at the end. I thought I was gonna be by myself the whole night. Out of nothing.
Yeah.
People just show up. There's a guy on the side of the road cheering me. Bam! Hey! Hey! Nou, ik ga niet uit drinken, want dat is niet corona-proof. Fucking corona. Stupid corona. Is het koud?
Ja.
Ja,
is wat je mag van toch?
Goed zo. Oké.
Yay!
Oké, thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Proost.
Nu wel een beetje wankelig. Alcohol after activity is the worst for recovery. But some occasions you can make an exception.
I can't remember all the names right now, but I want to thank everybody from the first guy from Germany, Stefan, to these guys at the end. Cherk is the last one to join us, like right around the corner. Everyone who was on the side of the road cheering for me, there actually were a lot of people. Of course, my parents and Bruno in the follow car, all the people that helped me out. A big thank you to everyone. And it was a big success. That's for sure. Cycling fanatics. Okay guys, leave a comment. Tell me what you think of this challenge. And tell me what you think what my next challenge should be. Down below. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification. I'm gonna see you next time. See ya! This is Noordkaap, officially the most northerly point of the Netherlands. A very nice ending point of today. And that's it. I'm done. I want to eat and sleep and then repeat.
Cycle.
Ja, ik vind het mooi geweest.